unserem IBC-Report 2014 haben wir Metus Marm schon einmal vorgestellt. Jetzt wollen wir uns ein bisschen einen Workflow anschauen, eine ganz typische Anforderung, nämlich was passiert, wenn ich viel Material habe, wie gehe ich dann eigentlich vor, wie kann ich mit Metus Marm entsprechend arbeiten. Bei mir steht jetzt Hardy, das ist ein Mitarbeiter von Metus aus den USA und er wird uns ein bisschen durch das Programm führen und uns zeigen, wie man von vielen Clips zu einem organisierten Arbeiten kommt. Hi Hardy, can you show us a little bit what is a typical way of working with Marm and when you start with a bunch of clips, what do you do?
Yeah, we've been out all day, we've shot a lot of great clips, but now how to organize them, how to search for them, how to find them, not just the day after you get back, but 6 months later when you've forgotten everything about the scenes and what you've done. So in this scene here, we've got several clips. I will select all the clips. And we will drag them into the MAM system. And it is bringing those clips in right now. At that point, we'll be able to see them. We'll be able to tag them with metadata. We'll be able to add more metadata to be able to do things like approvals. We could do drop-down list, location-based, all sorts of ways that you can think of to search and find the footage that you need quickly. You need to be in the business of editing, not searching.
So basically, we can see there's a lot of clips, nature, life, and different kinds of animals. So the typical way now would be to just, in few words, say what is the content of each clip, right?
Right, we do a brief either by the name of the clip, we would name it with something, or in the metadata. And then whether or not you were able to save your metadata for how it was shot, those are additional fields. But we can create more metadata for who shot it, when they shot it. We actually can set up templates so you have it set that it's for a specific shoot, a specific day. All these things can be brought in and that metadata can be brought in from there without you entering it manually for each clip.
And if I have understood it right, it's like this, that you can organize your clips on your own, but it's also a multi-platform, so other people can work on your footage. So you could hire a student, say, okay, please tag my material, because yeah, totally. I have thousands of clips. And then another person, an editor, has the possibility to address these clips, search the clips, and work with them.
And you can have multiple editors working on a project. Let's say you're working on a program, you can be doing different segments at the same time and having this all work there. Everybody's looking. The producers can be going offline without having to go into your edit bay and look at your stuff. You can even do rough cuts within here too. If you're a producer, here's what I roughly want, and send that to the editor. So then they can then refine it, add the effects, graphics, everything that's needed. We're here to help your workflow make you go faster.
That sounds great. Well, I think that you mentioned different editing solutions are possible for the system. What kind of editing solutions do you support right now?
Right now we have a direct plugin for Edius by Grass Valley. We also have a plugin for Premiere. For the Creative Cloud, and now we have support for Adobe Anywhere as well. We have a Mac client, desktop client for use with people with Final Cut, and with people with Avid, all you basically do is you grab the AAF file, drag that to your desktop, and then drag it into your project. Or if you have a library project, you could do that directly. So
I could hear that the integration with Edius is very well. With other programs, it's also nice, but maybe with Edius, it's working very fluently and very nicely.
They work hand in glove, and we probably have a very long relationship with Edius in terms of how we've been able to work and adapt to what their workflow is.
Now
we also do Sony Vegas as well. So. Sorry, Sony.
Okay, so you allow even people to work on EDS and Adobe Premiere at the same time with the same footage.
Correct. And depending on the type of codec you have, you can even do live ingest with our other product, Ingest, and you can edit while you're still ingesting it. So if you're doing live events.
Yeah, the solution Metis Ingest, we have made a film about this, how it works, and this edit while capture functionality. So the integration of Ingest with MAM is also working. You can have metadata directly in Ingest.
Correct. I can set up a metadata template. I don't want to be too complicated, but a metadata template within MAM, and then I can recall that in Ingest so that when I ingest the file, it already has the metadata already on there for most of what you're looking at. In addition, in Ingest, I can have multiple operators adding live metadata as the event is going on.
So I understand that the system is built to organize thousands of clips for, you have one company and you have, I don't know how many people working there, and people can work with the system, all the clips get into the system, some tag it, some edit the material. But I can imagine if now somebody is just having a small laptop and the other person having a big editing station, how will that work?
Well, one of the nice things about MAM is it is completely scalable. We have one installation that will have over 4,000 clients and 18 petabytes, but we also have setups where you have one or two users only and maybe 10 terabytes of storage that they're looking at. MAM can adapt and grow to where your needs are today and in the future. In terms of talking with a laptop, they can either use the desktop client or we have what's called MAM, which is Metis Online. So I can be out in the field with a laptop or with an iPhone or an Android, and I can grab, I can search, I can upload and download video anywhere.
But the files are really big, so how is this handled?
We have the proxies, and the proxies, we're very flexible in what type of proxies that you are looking for. If you've got a system where you already had an asset manager and it's starting to get old and clunky, you can change over to MAM and we can take those proxies without you having to create new ones, or we can make new ones as well.
So speaking about metadata, can you show us how to add some metadata, some description for a clip?
Okay, so already when your clip comes in, you usually will have some metadata already. So in the area I have the ID, the name of the file, when it was created, when it was modified, depending on what's available, there may be more or less. And here we've added a description where I say for the Mardi Gras parade, I will say great parade. And then for the waterfalls, beautiful view. So then I can go back and search for that later. Other ways that I can search looking for footage, I click on my search area. I have a regular Google style, so what do we say, beautiful view. And that clip comes up. But we can also go a little bit quicker, more advanced. I could actually drag areas of metadata over without having to type, find out which ones of these are in, and I can change which ones I search for, multiples or just one, and then search and quickly come up with the clip I'm looking for.
Yeah.
Now, in addition to that, for the people who are metadata, we can also do categories as well.
Yeah.
Unlimited categories, as many as you want, as many as you want to set them up in. But also we have an image-based. So for the people who are metadata challenged, they hate to put their own info in. Let's say they had a project they did 3 years ago, and there was a shot. They have the shot archived, but they have no idea what it's called or where it's at. With the MAM system, we come in and we will look. We previously grabbed a still, and we can actually, by an algorithm, look at the shot and the values of it, to see what matches it closely. So what it did was the ones that we did the image index search, we're able to go back and find, there's the shot we had. It is also in this shot, which was several shots, and you see the red, which is the location of where that shot is as well.
Wow, that's amazing. So it's really looking for a picture and finding it in a scene somewhere. Wow, that's really practical.
Absolutely.
So the possibility to look, to search for clips inside Mitos MAM is really nice. Is it also possible to then use some kind of plugin inside the editing solution to search for clips?
Absolutely. I will open up Edius, and I can come in and I'll do a text search for the beautiful view we did earlier. And there's the clip we're looking for. I can just drag that straight down to the timeline right within Edius.
Wow, that's really, really nice. I think a lot of our customers will get their material get organized now when they see this. So thank you very much for showing us.
Thank you.
And continue to have a great NAB.
You too.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.